Hello, my name is Nitin. Today, I have some exciting news to share. SPEAG has just released version 1.4 of the DASY8 3D software. The automation of CSR3D with the DASY8 robot. In my previous video about version 1.2, I had tested the call box integration. Well, the new version goes several steps further. First, it extends the call box support to 5G. Next, it adds support for XTEM combiner measurements, which means I can now test up to 10 GHz. So even devices with Wi-Fi 6E capability can be evaluated. Next, the graphical user interface has several improvements that allow quick and easy device under test teaching. In this video today, I will test how good these new features are. I will use this mobile phone. As the phone has a camera extrusion, I need to do careful micro adjustments to get 0.1 millimeter positioning accuracy. I have already entered the dimensions of the mobile phone device in the DUT setup tab. For micro adjustments, I select the back position and click the new Use Teach Pendant button. This option allows me to move closer to the robot with the teach pendant in my hand. As you can see, the DASY8 3D teach buttons are now active in the teach pendant screen itself. This makes moving the robot and the teaching process very easy and accurate, as I don't have to control movements back and forth from the computer screen. I quickly adjust the X and Y positions first, followed by the orientation angles, and finally the Z position. Once the micro adjustments for this position are finished, I press the save button on the teach pendant. So the new DASY8 3D is very tightly integrated with the robot application, and SPEAG mentioned that this required substantial effort to achieve. For the user, this saves tremendous effort, as I can now quickly and more accurately teach several devices together and later run measurements on them in tandem. I now set up the measurement project for the mobile phone to test the 5G base station simulator integration. I have a project file already set up to measure 5G new radio on band 78, 100 megahertz bandwidth, UPSK 1 resource block. I have an Anritsu MT8000A BSS connected to the DASY8 3D hub. The project has test cases to measure the back of the phone with separation distances from 0 mm to 10 mm. And back with a step size of 1 millimeter. For distances closer than 1 millimeter, the step size is 0.2 millimeter with the extend function enabled. The extend function performs 4 measurements per distance and therefore doubles the sensor resolution. This greatly improves the precision for very localized specific absorption rate. So we are now ready to measure. I move to the measurements tab, select all test cases and click measure. The new 5G call box support feature connects the call. The robot proceeds to pick up the device and moves it to the flat phantom for the first test case of the project. Since the measurement is with the X10 combiner, the robot intelligently offsets the device on the flat phantom for multiple measurements. At the end of the individual test case, The extend combiner evaluates the measurements and provides a combined 1 gram or 10 gram SAR value. I accelerate the video for the other measurements. The measurements are now complete. The measurements took 7 minutes. The measurement table now also shows the measurement type, extend or single, and the reports also indicate the same. I export the results to Excel and plot the forward and reverse measurements. These are almost identical. The measurements are quite repeatable. The DASY8 3D version 1.4 thus brings the complete power of the SESAR 3D test system into the user's hands. The integration of DASY8 3D application into the robot system allows the user to complete complex DUT or phantom teaching maneuvers quickly, easily, and yet more accurately than ever before. The integration of the X10 combiner allows measuring devices with sharp distributions or higher frequencies to overcome the fixed grid limitations of the vector SAR array measurement system. And finally, the BSS extension to cover 5G test cases is a much needed feature, as most devices are now 5G enabled. Thank you, SPEAG, for this new update. Thanks for watching this video.